Okay, the first characteristic is change in color. Okay, there are many chemical changes where the initial color of the solutions are different, but after adding them to some other chemicals, they change color. Okay, now here the first example is changing of color of an cut apple when kept in open. Okay, now if we cut an apple into slice and kept it in the open for some time, the slice of apple acquire a brown color due to the formation of new substance. Okay, now this happens due to the reaction of oxygen and acid in the apple. Similarly, if you have observed a cut surface of brinjal or potato also turns red if it is being kept in air. Now this is again due to the chemical change. Okay, if you see the second example, colorless phenolphthalein. Phenolphthalein, I don't know how many of you know, but it is an indicator to check whether the solution is base or acid. Okay, so when it is colorless, when colorless phenolphthalein is added to dilute sodium hydroxide. Now sodium hydroxide here is a base. Okay, the solution turns pink. So here again you see the change in color. Further, bursting of firecrackers. Okay, if you you all must have seen, okay, that when firecrackers burst, we can see lots of colors in the sky due to various chemical reactions that takes place, because it contains chemicals like potassium nitrate, potassium chlorate, barium, and sulfur filled in them. And lastly, the brownish color rust, which we have already seen, right, that the iron object get rusted due to the deposition of brown color substance. It is again a chemical reaction where iron reacts with moisture in the air. Okay, so there also you can see the change in color. And lastly, if you see the diagram here, I've just mentioned an experiment where actually you can see how the color changes. Okay, so this is about the reaction between copper sulfate solution and iron nail. The copper sulfate solution is blue in color when the iron nail is being dipped in this copper sulfate solution, and if you observe after 1 or 2 days, you will see that the solution turns green. Now why the solution turns green is there is there is a chemical reaction between copper sulfate and the iron nail, which produce two new substances, that is iron sulfate and copper. Iron sulfate is green in color, whereas the brown deposit on the iron nail is of copper. Okay, so here again you see a major color change. So I hope that you understood the first characteristics, that chemical reaction is characterized by change in color. The second characteristics is change in energy. In some of the chemical changes, the energy is either absorbed or released. This energy can be in the form of heat energy, it can be in the form of light energy or electrical energy. Okay, the most common type of energy or change in energy is found with respect to heat energy. Okay, so based on the absorption or release of heat energy, the chemical changes or say the chemical reactions are classified into exothermic reaction or say exothermic change, or endothermic reaction or endothermic change. Now if you see the diagram here, first diagram, first beaker, you can see the arrows are shown upward. Okay, that means the heat is released. So whenever heat has been released, it is an exothermic reaction. And in the second diagram, the arrow is downward. So here the heat has been absorbed. Okay, so whenever the heat has been absorbed, it is an endothermic reaction. We'll see exothermic and endothermic reaction in detail for the exothermic reaction. Okay, the chemical reactions or changes in which heat is released, or you can also say heat is been given out or heat is been liberated during the reaction, are called as exothermic reactions or exothermic changes. Now these are the examples for the same for the exothermic reaction. Here when carbon is heated in air, okay, that time carbon dioxide is formed, and with the formation of carbon dioxide, heat is been released, heat energy is been given out. Okay, so this is an exothermic reaction. The second example is when water is added to calcium oxide. Okay, that time again a new substance is formed, that is calcium hydroxide, with release in heat energy. So even there you can see heat energy has been given out with the formation of new substance, that is calcium hydroxide. Okay, the opposite of exothermic reaction is endothermic reaction. Okay, now in endothermic chemical reaction, the heat is absorbed. Okay, so boiling of an egg, baking biscuits, these are the examples. So what there the heat is been absorbed. Okay, so what we can say about endothermic reaction is the chemical reaction or changes in which heat is absorbed during the reaction are called endothermic reaction or endothermic changes. Okay, now here the examples are like when carbon and sulfur are heated, heat is absorbed and carbon disulfate is produced. So this is the reaction for the same C plus S, that is 2S. When heated, it gives you carbon disulfide, that is CS2. Okay, now here the heat is been absorbed. Okay, the second example is of when nitrogen and oxygen are heated strongly, nitric oxide is formed, and again here if you see, it's again heating. So for the formation of nitric oxide, heat is again been absorbed. Okay, so this is all about exothermic and endothermic reaction. And thus we see that the energy in some chemical reactions, the energy is either absorbed or it is being released. So there is change in energy. Okay, let's see the third characteristics of chemical reaction, which is change in state. Okay, so many chemical reactions involve chemical change in which the state changes. Okay, so the first example here is when electricity is passed through water. Now here water is in liquid state, okay, and we are passing electricity through water. What is the reaction? It gives us hydrogen gas and oxygen gas. Now here the liquid gets converted to gas, which is a chemical reaction, and here you can find the state change. Liquid gets converted to gas, so easily you can make out that yes, there is a change in the state. See the second example. Again, when you have hydrogen gas and oxygen gas, so when hydrogen combines with oxygen, water is formed. Now here two gases turns into a liquid. Okay, so electricity is an important condition for this reaction to occur, and thus we can, in both the reactions, we can see the change in the state. Okay, apart from change in color, change in energy, change in state. There are other characteristics, I think, which I have already discussed when I started with the characteristics of chemical change. Okay, so still I'll just go through it quickly. Generation of smell. Yes, some chemical changes release characteristic smell along with other substance. Okay, then secondly, releasing of sound and light, which I have already explained you, that when a magnesium ribbon burns, it gives you white dazzling flame, and also a very minute cracking sound comes with it. Okay, so that is an example, best example. Further, last is about formation of precipitate. Yes, in a chemical change, sometimes a cloudy precipitate is formed when two liquid reactants react with each other. Okay, now this precipitate is solid, it is insoluble substance which is formed in the solution. So this is all about the characteristics of a chemical change, and further we are going to start with the types of chemical reactions. So thank you.